you know, since this is theater, and that's all this is today, is theater. This is, as we started out the conversation, the oldest continuous committee in the United States Congress. And without a hearing, you're going to proceed with the great charade. Mr. Bartold, I'd like to call the head of the Department of Revenue Services from the state of Connecticut. Have you heard from him?
I have not received a phone call.
Has he been called as an expert witness? No, he hasn't been called as an expert witness. And the transfer that's going to take place, I'll take Lee Zeldin's comments about the transfer of wealth from one region of the country to the other on the backs of hardworking people of the middle class. You talk about taxing success. All of our working professionals, whether you're a machinist or a teacher, and in the case of a teacher, if they reach into their pocket, if they reach into their pocket to pay for their students, you get rid of that deduction as well. So you can give it to somebody who's already got an $11 million deduction on the estate tax. This is outrageous. You are all good and honorable people. It is hard to believe that we find ourselves in this situation. You just went through this with the Health Care Act. The American public just witnessed again what happens when you jam something down. And for the American public, understand what's going on here today is 24/16. That's the only thing you need to know for this discussion and debate today. Mr. Bartold, I apologize to you and your hardworking staff because you're merely a showpiece today for your camouflage for what's really going on here. It's been stated over and over again that they need a political win. You know who needs a win? The American people need a win. They need to see us acting in regular order, responsibly. Mr. Neal pointed out in his opening remarks, in the Tax Reform Act of 86, 30 hearings were conducted in this committee, 12 in the subcommittee, 450 expert testimonies. We have none. None. No one was allowed to come forward. As Mr. Doggett pointed out, no one from the administration will even sit in front of us. We're the oldest committee in Congress, many would argue the most prestigious, and members on this side of the aisle aren't even entitled to bring an expert witness on any aspect of the tax code that affects 100% of our economy. 100% of the economy is impacted. And people in my state, in the middle class, are going to get a tax increase. A tax increase, thanks to the myriad of lists of things that you've decided behind closed doors that they, because they make itemized deductions, will no longer have. They'll no longer have the state and local tax deduction. 4,000 eliminated from the personal exemption. Medical expenses, no longer. Eliminates deductions for student loans and adoption and teacher education for the classroom and employer-provided education assistance. Why? Because they've made a decision behind closed doors, not with any experts or testimony, but they've made the decision that this is the way it's going to be. And the vote will proceed like that in the committee. Check me if I'm wrong on this. It's going to be 24-16 right down the line, all the way until they can get this to the floor of the House. And then on the floor of the House, they'll continue to perpetuate this great myth that somehow we went through any kind of regular order or there was any bipartisanship that was alluded to. These are honorable people. This is not an honorable time or day for this committee or for democracy in America. Not a single hearing or a single expert witness.